No clue.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the DC Wilcutt Gymnasium for the third place game of the DC Wilcutt Tournament. A lot of Wilcutt references tonight. Of course, the legendary CBC coach would be very proud to see what this tournament has become. And in fact, he is. He's not able to be in attendance tonight, but we know he is following the tournament anyway. So, coach, if you're watching, we want to welcome you to your tournament. I am Tom Eichwald. I'll be bringing you the game tonight on Cadet Student Network. Alongside me, Coach Corey Bethany. Corey, nice to have you in the broadcast.
Nice to be here. Good Friday evening.
It is, and we've got this game for you here. You just saw a tip-off, and we will be bringing you CBC versus Ladue in the championship game immediately following this, so you will want to stick around. Should be a fun night of basketball. And we'll dive right into the action here. Scoreless 30 seconds in. You have the Warriors from St. Charles West. They are wearing the black uniforms tonight, and in the white and green, the Panthers of Fort Zumwalt North. So it should be a fun one. Two teams coming off of roughly 10-point losses, a similar margin of victory in the semifinal, and certainly looking to bounce back and get something out of the tournament, I would think. But not the game you want to play in, I suppose, but a game you definitely want to win once you're there.
Absolutely. They're trying to get the score figured out, I think, and trying to see who's the home team, who's the away team. St. Charles had a quick bucket off the tip-off.
Yeah, and they're giving it to them. So they're going to be the guests in black tonight. So the home Panthers of Fort Zumwalt North in the white. And Fort Zumwalt North, and there you see the offensive foul. Fort Zumwalt North, of course, losing to CBC just the other night. St. Charles West, obviously, losing to Ladue. So
that's the championship game, right? CBC
that is.
And Ladue.
CBC Ladue.
Third straight year for it.
It is. It is. A game that's worked out well in CBC's favor the last few times. Again, if you are a fan of St. Charles West or Zumwalt North, we want to welcome you to the broadcast on the Cadet Student Network. We're happy to have you with us. And we hope you enjoy this game. Should be a lot of fun. Here you see West bounce around the outside. Unable to get it to go there was Drew Lauer. And finally, they get one to go from the outside.
Gantz.
Yeah, that was Logan Gantz. Definitely a player to watch out for St. Charles West. One of their leading scorers, I believe.
You're absolutely right. Averaging 16 points a game.
That's handy to have. So only needs about five more of those and a free throw. Or I guess four more now. So here is.
Oh, man, he's wide open down low.
He is. There's the bucket, the conversion from Sam Bartlett.
He was shocked to be that wide open. Yeah. He turned around, thought he had a defender in his face, and there was no one. Everyone else was on the side of the paint.
It's one you got to hit, but sometimes you see it miss simply because they can't believe they got the ball in there.
He got it to go.
And there you see the three does not go.
Look at the big hustle by the big fella.
There it is. That's some good hustle. That's what you want to see there from Drew Lauer. No, correction. That is Tommy Whitney.
Big Tommy.
He's a big fella, and you love the effort early on. And here's Gantz. He's going to swing it out wide. Back to Gantz. We're here on the near side. He's got Davis Soderberg. Yes, that Soderberg. And he's going to pass it in the corner before getting it back.
Looks like Zumwalt North is in a 3-2 zone. Extended. That's Big Tommy. He got the ball in the paint. Drew the foul, two hands in the back. Can't do that.
Well, and I was just about to compliment the defense of Zumwalt North. Very quick feet in the zone. And, of course, you need to be especially down low with the 3-2. That is one of the things you got to watch out for, of course, is that that kind of low corner three-point shot, kind of around that corner. When you got the two men, you get the quick the quick shot sometimes. So we'll have to see, especially if you can get Gantz in that kind of position, even though he's a point guard, get him down there with the shooting ability he has.
Another thing is the offensive rebounds. In zone, you got to find a body and put them on it, and they got two offensive rebounds in that possession. Something to look out for towards down line end of the game.
Right, and there's a good defensive rebound from Schwett.
Man to man here by St. Charles West.
And there's the shot from the rebounder, Schwett, and it doesn't go. And he gets his own rebound and stripped out of his hands. I think Gantz is a little confused, thought he got all ball, but
He passed it to Gantz. Gantz was looking down in court. Like, Oh, that wasn't Gons. I'm sorry. That was 30. They don't have 30.
Hassan DeCarolis. Hope DeCarolis, maybe.
DeCarlos.
DeCarolis. I don't know. We're hoping we're getting that name right. if you are the DeCarolis family and you like to correct us on the pronunciation of your last name, you can feel free to tweet us at CBCCSN. We accept shout-outs, in-game messages, anything you want to get out, and also corrections of last names. Certainly something we are sometimes in need of here in the booth. 4:45 to go. Charles West moving it around again. Gantz.
Look how far the extended that defense is on that three.
Yeah, and the pass inside from Pato gets goes out off of Tommy Whitney, so it's going to be an inbound. You were saying, Coach, sorry.
They extended that defense far out so they can make longer passes and cause problems and created a turnover there.
Here is North.
This guy can shoot it.
That was Zach Glotta, the leading scorer for Zumwalt North, averaging, 22 points a game?
That's right. I believe he's at 22.1. So right at 22.
Well, will you give me 22? Are you going to count me off for the 0.1?
We are in
a school after all. You want to be precise.
I'm telling you, you want to get him going. He can shoot it.
That is true. Just under four to go now. 6-5, Zumwalt North. So not a lot of scoring going on out there. It's kind of a chess match, really, at this point. You mentioned the zone versus the man-to-man. Can you break down a little bit of the tactics of what we're seeing now? Because it really has been kind of an interesting, totally different styles on defense and offense. What are we seeing now?
Look at the defense. Zumwalt North, all white, all the guys in the white jerseys all have their hands up. They all extending the play. So look how far away St. Charles West is from the basket. See, that's a deep three there, off, and they get the rebound. So St. Charles West got to find a way to attack, get inside that zone maybe.
And there you see they are going to give him two. That was Justin Fitzpatrick with the three. And we haven't had much opportunity based on time of possession, but what are we seeing from at the other end? Next time we go down there, let's look at what Zumwalt North is doing, because obviously with with St. Charles West playing the man-to-man instead, it's going to be a little bit different approach. But right now, St. Charles West trying to keep us from having that conversation. Here's Gantz.
They don't mind shooting the outside shot.
Doesn't go. And there's the game's leading rebounder, Austin Schwett. And so what are we seeing here tactically, Corey?
Well, St. Charles West is in a man-to-man. So you're seeing a lot of picks. Right now they're in a four-high set. West is not. They're just slow on rotating and switching out on defense.
And the way to beat a team that's a little slow on that is
quick ball movement, get the shot up. You should have wide open shots, and just make them. You know, they're getting the good looks that they're wanting. They just got to make it. So we'll see. Another deep three by St. Charles West.
And if you're Zumwalt North, I got to say you're probably relatively content with giving them NBA threes.
Oh yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Let them beat you that way.
As long as they find a body and rebound and box out. And they gave up a couple of offensive rebounds already. So there's Gotti again.
Doesn't go. Tommy Whitney almost put it in his own hoop. That wouldn't have been good, but fortunately he's bailed out there by the rim. And coming back for West, this is Davis Soderberg.
I wouldn't mind seeing West pushing the ball a little bit. They had an opportunity there. Good move by Gons there, drawing the foul.
That was. He's going to get the block. Well, we have a second. We mentioned D.C. Wilcutt Tournament. Of course, a fine tradition here. CBC would like to thank all of the teams competing this week as we honor D.C. Wilcutt, a legendary coach, educator, and administrator who spent 35 years at CBC. During his career, Coach Wilcutt led the cadets to 3 state championships, 14 district titles, and a total of 570 wins. He is a member of the Missouri Coaches Hall of Fame. Most important, though, of course, Coach was a mentor and friend to so many during his time at CBC, and we're so grateful for all he gave to our school. Such an honor to be able to have this tournament to honor him in his gymnasium, the D.C. Wilcutt Gymnasium. I want to thank you for joining us on the Cadet Student Network. Tom Eichwald alongside Corey Bethany. Minute and a half to go here in the first quarter, and Zumwalt North leading 8-5 over St. Charles West, who's Got to say, dominated the possession game a little bit, but just not with the points to show for it.
It's just going back and forth on the perimeter. They got to get the ball inside. I will put someone either on the free throw line, the elbow, short corner, overload. They got to be able, there he is. See that? Right there on the elbow, in and out game. Good shot. Good open shot. I got to make it, kid.
Right, and that was a good look there for Ben Pato. And at the other end, here is...
This is lazy defense. You can't let a guy catch that deep inside, especially a big body guy like that. Now, he may not be a scorer, but still, he's scoring right there.
Yep.
He's in too deep on your defense.
Yeah, it's Blake Wilson with the points. So inside of a minute now, we're at 39 seconds, actually. 10-5, Zumwalt North. And with the ball for West, Matt Fraser goes inside to Tommy Whitney. Can't get it to go.
Big fella got to get off the ground. He's not jumping.
Yeah, it looked like Brendan Orff got up and over him, touched it out of bounds, but it's going to be a St. Charles West inbound here. Again, trailing by 5 with 26 to go
off the back. Oh. Trying to get a sneak.
It looks great, especially when it goes in, but might as well try. You can see he kind of claps his hands in frustration there.
It's one of those you look genius doing it.
Yep. Got to get it to go, though. 8 seconds.
You know he's shooting. Off the pick. From deep. Bang.
There it is. So 13-5, and that's going to do it for the first quarter. We are going to take it to a word from one of our sponsors, I think. Yes? When we get back, we will get you set for second quarter action here on CSN.
One of my favorite spots is the Cafe Afton, the home of the CBC Burger. The owner, Craig Smellick, is a huge CBC fan, and he always treats me right. Located on Gravois Road, the Cafe Afton is a great place to stop after a CBC hockey game, or for any occasion for that matter. Just ask my wife. I'm always looking for an excuse to pay Craig a visit at the Cafe Afton. I know you'll love it too. Please be sure to tell them that you're a CBC fan and that Rocky sent you. That's the Cafe Afton, home of the CBC Burger, located on Gravois Road.
And welcome back to the booth, the Tim Kylo broadcast booth here at DC Wilcutt Gymnasium. We are getting you set. Of course, you're seeing the video from Charter. Charter CCIN is carrying this game, but we are bringing you the audio along with their video. So we're grateful to our friends over at Charter for helping us with this and letting us tag along. So we want to thank them.
Big time, and now.
We are. And you can help us be big time by sharing us on social media. You can send your friends, refer all your friends, at CBCCSN on Twitter.
Get us trendy.
Yeah, the Cadet Student Network on Facebook. Pass us around. And there you see another bucket there. That was another one for Blake Wilson. We saw him score right at the end. And definitely seems to be a little bit of a soft underbelly inside for West defensively.
You can get inside real easy against West. I like to see him pick up the tempo on the defensive end.
So about a half a minute into the second quarter, 15-5, 10-point lead for Zumwalt North. Of course, a lot of basketball to play, nowhere near panic mode, but still, you'd like to get a few on the board here just to give yourself a little bit of belief going into halftime. There's the shot, and that one can't go, but Tommy Whitney with the rebound and draws the foul. There you saw the shot coming from Hassan Decarolis. DeCarolis.
Let's call him Hassan DC.
There we go. We'll call him Hassan. How about
Hassan.
That?
There we go. We got that one.
We think we got that one. And here's Whitney at the line. So important to have a big man who can make free throws, isn't it?
It's always nice. Always but nice to have a big man to do anything.
Fair point. But, of course, when you got a guy who can make the free throws, you know, you don't want to, and I can't get that one to go, but of course you don't want to, you know, let him have easy buckets, but at the same time, you know that you can't avoid the problem, you know, the old Shaq syndrome,
right,
where you just foul him and he can't make anything from the line. So it's kind of a double threat there.
Absolutely.
Full timeouts taken by St. Charles West. While we have a second, we want to ask you, CBC fans, are you protected? Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo. That's K-I-L-O. for all your insurance needs. Tim is more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of CSN, and we are incredibly grateful for his support. Call Tim at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. So that's if you need insurance. If you need an attorney, well, you want someone you can count on to protect your legal rights. The attorneys at Milliken Wright are here for you. Brian Milliken and CBC grad Chris Wright have fiercely represented the injured and accused in civil and criminal cases in the St. Louis metropolitan area for more than 15 years. Call Brian and Chris at 314-621-0622 or find Milliken Wright online at www.millikenwright.com. Milliken Wright will fight for you. So we hope you're enjoying this one. Again, you're watching the Cadet Student Network. This is a student-led broadcasting initiative. This is entirely done by the students. We, of course, talk into the microphones, but all of the planning, all the technology support, the meetings where they schedule what we need, they budget, they do everything that we do at the network, is all done by our students. I got a list of names of students helping with the broadcast, and I will get to it at the next stoppage. But right now we got St. Charles West on the ball. And here's a shot from the corner. And that one does go. That's Ben Pato. Missed one a few minutes ago, and he's got it now.
Watch the intensity on the defense now.
Yeah, and there you see.
That's why the coach called timeout to pick it up. They was lackadaisical on the defensive end, and watch the intensity by West get brought up here on this to end the second half here, the first half.
Yeah, and so the contact against Austin Schwett there. Schwett's got a couple of rebounds and a few points tonight.
Might get 5 seconds. Oh, timeout there.
Yeah, that's a timeout called by Zumwalt North, I believe. And anyway, so the names of the students working the broadcast: Max Adamski, Johnny Althoff, John McQuaid, Kyle Hunt, John Rolfe, and Tony Gambino. And leaving himself off the list, our fearless leader, executive producer, Bryson Schroeder. He does not like getting credit, folks, but he does a phenomenal job and really has this crew. The word on the street is that Bryson Schroeder tried to sabotage the broadcast beforehand just to see if he could mess with some of the younger guys working board, and they figured it out. So that's the kind of work we're doing here on CSN. So congrats on the great work being done by our students. So with 6.5 to go, 17-9. Zumwalt North. Again, Zumwalt North in the white, St. Charles West wearing the black away uniforms. And there you see potentially another easy inside bucket.
Yeah, that was good play set up by the Panthers, though.
That was. And he got the layup, just didn't go. And there's Schwett. Can't get it to go, and Whitney with the rebound. Good rebound from Tommy.
Somebody put a lid on that hoop there. A lot of easy buckets rattled in and out.
And Pato does a nice job of controlling. Keeping it in, and he's going to swing it back up to the top. And controlling it now is Sasan. Passes to Gantz. Now Davis Soderberg back to Gantz. Thinks about the shot. Soderberg's got all kinds of space over there. And here is Sasan. Back to Gantz.
I need to get someone on the free throw line. Break down the middle. Right there at the elbow. They're just missing it. I think they got the wrong guy there.
Yeah, they got it is Pato there. We've seen him mostly shoot from outside. I think Soderberg's making his way now,
yeah.
Probably more the guy you want there.
Exactly.
And he's going to try to dictate the free throw line physically here and just create a little bit of opportunity for somebody else. And there you see Gantz finding his way into the corner. That's a dangerous position for him given the zone set up by Zumwalt North. But they're going to keep it on the other side. Here's Pato. Soderberg goes for the...
That's a settle.
That's quite a three.
That's that offensive rebound I talked about earlier.
Yep. Boy, I mean, in the attacking half, West has to be out-rebounding North in that half of the court.
Yeah.
I mean, it's got to be 70-30, 80-20 maybe. Maybe 90-10.
Coach Glotta yelling, you can block them out. But, I mean, if they take long three-point shots like that, you're going to get long rebounds. So, that's a tough job to do. You have to block them out almost to the perimeter.
And West, a little pump fake there from about 8 yards behind the free throw line, or the three-point line. And there's Whitney inside.
Inside.
Getting it done. So Tommy Whitney picking up his third point of the game.
Yeah, he had free throws. He hit the
Yeah, he had the one free throw. Makes it really easy to calculate his free throw percentage so far tonight. And this is going to be a north ball. Is there a problem with the ball? They're trying to the ball wet?
I'm laughing at the coach. He says, you were open. Shoot it. I tell you what, we got some guys on the CBC staff. I mean, on the team. If they're open, they're shooting.
Oh, yeah. See, that was my specialty back when in my playing days.
Of course,
it never went in, but I got great looks. It was like they were
You knew how to get open.
It was like they were letting me shoot. It was wonderful. I was that guy out
there.
That's
a self-check.
Yeah, they leave me the open shot knowing they're probably going to get the rebound.
I think we did have a ball issue, a wet ball.
I wonder if it splashed a little too close to the cooler.
Yep.
You spilled a cup of water or something. And here is Glada. Glada, of course, very much the danger man for Zumwalt North based on the scoring, 22 points a game, 22.1 we mentioned earlier.
He's the man. I remember last year in this tournament, him and his brother put on a show. I think one of them, if I think it was him, he scored 40, maybe 30. I know he had a lot of points.
Well, that would honestly, that would be a bit of a surprise based on the first half
there's
of this one, scoring-wise.
He's a shooter, and once he gets hot, it's all it takes.
Yeah, I can't get that one to go either. So 3:50 to go here in the second quarter, 17-11 North. So the lead as big as 10 tonight, back down to 6.
There it is. You got to look to shoot that. Once you get inside there on the free throw line, you got to look to shoot. Be a shooter. Attack the basket from there.
Was that Pato again, the guy you think's probably not the right guy for that, that position? And making his way into the game for Zumwalt North, Nick Novato. He has taken the place of Austin Schwed, who's had a pretty good game so far, been very involved. And there's a lovely three.
It's Hassan, our boy.
Yeah, Hassan. And that's 14 all of a sudden. So a three-point game now. And Zumwalt North trying to answer. Of course, you'd like to keep the lead going into halftime, or at least not forfeit the momentum, even if you know that's probably more important than the lead at this point.
Tommy Whitney gets caught looking a lot. Offensive charge there. Hassan taking a charge.
Looking ball watching, as we say in soccer.
Ball watching, yes. Yep. He get caught ball watching. And not really fighting his guy off the block. And they getting easy catches inside.
Yeah,
some offense set to expose that a lot more than what they're doing.
And here is Soderberg. One of the biggest fellows on the court, and he's playing up top as a point guard almost. There he goes.
Yeah, he's like a wing. He'll be a wing guy. I would like to see him there at that free throw line because he can shoot it.
Yeah, there you see Gantz trying to drive, can't get that to go. And controlling nicely there is Bartlett, Sam Bartlett, able to come up with the rebound. One of his foot slipped. Nice job body control to keep the other foot down. And here is Glada. He can't get that to go either. He's a little frustrated. Thought there was some contact. Here's Gantz.
Good.
Excellent hustle there. And a little contact afterward to boot from Sam Bartlett. Good hustle, good block from Bartlett. And here's Glada. Still can't get it to go. 2 minutes now. Three-point game. North in the lead. Soderberg from downtown, and he drains it.
He can shoot. They're going to count the basket, but it was a foul by Tommy.
Tommy Whitney underneath. So that makes it a tie game. Zumwalt North ball with a minute 53 to go here. Once more, CSN would like to thank all of our sponsors, like the Lab Gym on Manchester Road, Millpaws Piping and Supply, Let's Party Now Catering, and Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas. These loyal businesses make this broadcast possible, so be sure to support our sponsors. CBC Alumni Association and our admissions department also sponsor CSN, and we appreciate their support. 1:45 to go. Still tied. Zumwalt North working it around. Here's the shot. No good.
Short.
Yeah, a little short there from Justin Fitzpatrick.
Fitzpatrick coming off the bench, firing it up.
Now there's his first look at the hoop.
Yeah.
Not his best, but it's an experience he'll be better for, I'm sure, in this game. And here's Pato.
See, he doesn't know what to do. Once he gets the ball right there on the elbow, he needs to turn and face and draw the defense towards him.
I mean, is it the size mismatch that you kind of suggested earlier?
No, it's just got to be you have to trust someone at that free throw line to have ball skills and can actually knock it down. You got to be a threat. You always got to be a threat to score. You know, that's, you got to keep in mind the goal of the game is getting the ball through the hoop. And when you're playing defense, that is the biggest threat. So someone, he's not looking to shoot right there. He's getting the ball, and he's looking to dribble out or pass it outside. And defense are not respecting his threat.
Here's Glada at the line. Finally gets one to go. And interesting, gives Zach Glada a couple of free throws here right at the end of the first half. See if maybe just seeing the ball go through the hoop can do something for his confidence, because he's certainly a player that's been very, very frustrated by the rim, by a little bit of contact from a defender. So hasn't gone his way. He just hasn't been able to get anything to fall. But he does hit those two free throws, so we'll see if that does anything for his confidence. Here's the ball inside to Pato.
See, he's just
had the space for the shot there. Passes it up.
He's not even looking for it.
Here's Soderberg, and he can't get it to go. Uncontested rebound there for Brendan Orff. And now Glada with 42 to go. He's telling him to get moving. There's Glada. Orff. And he finally puts the ball on the floor. Good defense from West. Be able to control the switch. And coming out with it is Fitzpatrick.
I'll probably hold for the last shot here.
Yep, 15 seconds.
You know who's going to shoot it.
Yep. And I guess we'll see what those free throws did for him.
Well, he already knocked two threes down in the first half, so. Oh, he passed it.
And here's the lob. No, not time for it. That was off the rim, but it was late. That's going to bring us to halftime here on the Cadet Student Network. We are going to take you to a word from one of our sponsors, and when we come back, we will have a few more talking points for you before we get set for the second half. You're watching CSN.
Best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, business, or life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-4442. Or send him an email, tim@timkylo, K-I-L-O.
And welcome back. Before we wrap up the first half, you may have heard of this, especially if you're not new to CSN broadcasts. But in case you are, or in case you just wanted to hear it again, the Stand Up for CBC campaign is in full swing. So far, we've gotten a great response for our alums from supporters who are looking to help CBC prepare to educate the next generation of cadets. We've got a great campaign video that it's a student production. Everything was done by the students. So we hope you enjoy this video and making a donation. So Stand Up for CBC video right here.
I am one, but I'm not the only one. I can do some things, but I can't do everything. What I can do, ought to do, by the grace of God, I will do. For my God, for my school.
For my brothers!
All for all, God for us all. Christian Brothers on the move.
St. John Baptist de La Salle believed that everyone has been blessed by God with individual gifts and talents. These gifts and talents need to be recognized and celebrated. And that is what we're all about here at CBC. Our pledge to my brother promotes this idea that there is value in each of us individually. But it also recognizes that each of us has weaknesses as well. It is only when we as a community that we achieve our full potential. And that is the commitment or pledge that our young men make to one another. I am here for you when you need me. I will lift you up.
Being a CBC brother, to me it means being a part of something that's bigger than yourself. And being a part of something that you know is always going to be there as long as you live.
I remember, you know, growing up, and that really was kind of like my biggest dream was just to go to high school and graduate. I have cystic fibrosis, and so I had really bad lungs at the time. CBC, I remember them saying, you know, with my health, that if I ever were to get sick or whatnot, that they would help me get my homework in when I was in the hospital and I wouldn't be falling behind. They didn't just baby me along the course. They let me actually try to achieve it for myself.
I was wounded in 2004. A civilian vehicle crossed the center line and hit us head on. The first day I woke up, ironically enough, the first person I saw who wasn't in the military was my CBC classmate, Matt Peckham. Tells a lot about that the first person I saw outside of the military was someone who drove across Germany just to come see me. Knowing the friendship that we had, it did not surprise me at all. He would have stopped whatever he was doing and come to see me.
CBC is really all about relationships.
They come back to CBC because they know and sense and feel a tremendous brotherhood. And that benefits them for their future, but it also gives them a grounding that they can always come back to and feel comfortable being a part of. It's a tremendous thing.
When I think about myself being a brother to CBC, I just remember how coming here, you know, everybody was helping me out. I remember how being a brother, they always taught, you know, look out for one another.
The alumni are the stewards of this school, of the history of the school, of the legacy of the school. It only succeeds if we all make it that way and take care of it and make it successful.
It's more that feel of family and brotherhood that just it gives them incredible confidence to do good things.
The best reason anyone can support the school is to make sure that kids today have the same opportunity that we had.
I am the person I am today because of my experiences at CBC, because of who I met here at CBC, my friends, the teachers, the coaches.
You see them grow from, you know, little guys to these men that are doing incredibly valuable things. That makes us very proud here at CBC, that we've played a small part in that development. It's awesome.
CBC has a rich history in St. Louis, and you are each an integral part of that history. We need your help to continue the LaSallean traditions, the heritage of St. John Baptist de La Salle, and for future cadets that attend CBC. We would ask you to live the pledge, make your pledge, the campaign, Stand Up for CBC.
God for us all.
God for us all.
Christian brothers on the move.
Christian brothers on the move.
St. John Baptist de La Salle.
Pray for us.
Live Jesus in our hearts.
As you can tell from the video, great things are happening at CBC every day. Please visit www.standupforcbc.org to make your donation to this exceptional institution. Now is the time to stand up for CBC. Once again, that is standupforcbc.org. Well, we're back here in the booth, the Tim Kylo broadcast booth at DC Wilcutt Gymnasium. Tom Eichwald alongside Corey Bethany, bringing you the third place game of the DC Wilcutt tournament. One of our favorite weeks of the year, of course, for CBC basketball. So, Corey, bringing you back in here, what were your thoughts on the first half overall?
Good, tight, well-played basketball. I mean, I can see things where they can get improved, both teams. But, you know, it'll be close all the way towards the end of the game.
Right. And what would you say? Let's start with Zumwalt North because we're watching them warm up at this point. What would you say for Zumwalt North? What can they improve? What do they need to do going into the second half?
Well, they need to expose defense, the lack of defense of St. Charles West is playing. Get it inside. Don't settle for three. That may be their game. Glotta can shoot from the outside, but if it's not working, try to score inside the paint. They get in the looks. You know, they just got to finish.
And on the flip side for St. Charles West, who we see coming out right now?
St. Charles West need to either speed up the game and not allow them for Zumwalt North to get set up in their zone, or they need to figure out someone to attack the inside and the middle and be a threat in that position.
So as we see the teams get set, we do have another game tonight. If you're watching us, if you're a CBC fan, just checking in on the tournament. We will be bringing you the tournament final, CBC versus Ladue. As we said, third straight year we've had that matchup. And Coach Bethany, your thoughts on what we can expect in that game, the championship game?
CBC is a highly favorite for that game. It's not the same. You would say star power that we had in the previous years, but Ladue, they'll come to play. They know it's a championship game. They won the first time we played up out of the last three. We came back last year and beat them, and then this is almost like the rubber match.
So mentally for both teams coming in, of course, a lot to play for. And for CBC, certainly, in the D.C. Wilcutt tournament, your own gym, you certainly don't want to end it on a bad note. So we look forward to that one. That one's going to start at 8, so we will be back at 8 o'clock bringing you that one. But first, of course, we have another half of Zumwalt North versus St. Charles West. We're going to take you to one more word from our sponsors, and when we come back, we will be ready for tip-off here on CSN.
This is Frank Bomarito. Taking care of one of your most important investments should not be expensive. We take maintaining your vehicle seriously. We're fast, convenient, and the most competitive price in town. Trust the pros at Bomarito. We're in every neighborhood or 24/7 at Bomarito.com. This is Missouri's number one automotive group, Bomarito. Sixth, the Bomarito Automotive Group. Click, search, and save at Bomarito.com. Group, over 4,000 vehicles where price sells cars. Bomarito
College to professional and Olympic athletes, world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym will get you ready to compete at the highest level. Call Director of Sports Performance, Matt Miller, at 314-932-7270 or visit their website, labgym.com. Or just stop into the gym at 5035 Manchester Avenue to see for yourself.
Hey guys, this is Matt Miller with world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym. Make sure to check us out online, stop by, get a free tour. If you mention you're a friend.
And we're back here in the Tim Kylo broadcast booth on CSN. Tom Eichwell alongside Corey Bethany. Zumwalt North in the white, the home team tonight. They are up by 2, 19-17 after the first half. And we are underway in the second half here. St. Charles West, of course, in the visiting black. Looking to reverse their fortunes here. They've switched ends, but can they switch the scoreboard? The best they've been is, they were up 2 right off the tip, and then they've been trailing with the exception of a brief period tied. They were tied for about a minute or so. But here we see the early basket from Charles West, and they are tied again. Logan Gantz getting himself back on the board. So 7.5 to go, 19-19 here. Good, fun score for a basketball game, but we look to see again. Not all that high scoring in the first half. We'll see if it picks up a little bit, especially maybe legs start to get tired. Who knows? So here is Soderberg. These are for Gantz. It's about the second or third time Gantz has faked the shot from about 8 miles away from the basket. He's not happy about that.
He has to look to shoot. Threw it away. That's Pato, right?
Yes, 35.
Yeah. Last time down, he looked to shoot. They collapsed on him. He got it back out to Gantz. Gantz had opportunity to drive the hole. He made it like this time he didn't even threw it away.
And there's Glotta drives. So Glotta back on top, 21-19.
Glotta good to the cup, just like we said at halftime, what Zumwalt North could do, and it looked like they're looking at the attack that this half.
And you never know. You might be able to, and there we see the shot from putting one in. But just going to say, the little 1-2 punch. Start making West think you're going to attack inside. Go inside, go inside, go inside. Consolidate them a little bit. Mm-hmm. Then you get better shooting opportunities for Glad on the outside. And if you can pull off both of those, then you got them pretty disoriented. So we could see if Zumwalt North tries that approach.
Step back.
And Hassan can't get that one to go. Good rebound from Pedo. And here's Soderberg. Another pump fake from 8 miles.
That's deep.
And Gons can't get that one to go, and it's off the supports. So it's going to be Zumwalt North ball.
That's a settled shot. Settle, settle, settle.
Pretty early in that possession, too. We've seen him with long spells of possession in the opposing half, and that time I think maybe a little bit of a rush shot rather than being patient. But and there you see going to the hoop was Justin Fitzpatrick. Can't get it to go, though. And it's North's ball. Fitzpatrick inbounds. Tries to find Glada, but can't find him. Gontz is marking him.
And big man.
Yeah. That was the shot from outside by Blake Wilson. Doesn't go, though, and West wins the rebound. Soderberg gets it to go.
That's a hot spot on the floor right there.
It is. So that is the first lead of the game for St. Charles West since the opening seconds. So they're up 25-23. So here's Wilson.
Never looked at the basket.
And there's Glada driving in. It was a nice drive. He couldn't get it to go. Tried the reverse, and a brave cameraman takes one on the thigh there. Never stopped filming, of course. The mark of a pro. 5:15 to go. We do want to let you know you're watching Charter's video, CCIN, letting us borrow their video. We certainly appreciate that. We hope you're enjoying our audio as well. Getting the best of both worlds. And the same will be true, I believe, of the final game, the CBC Ladue as well. Here's Gontz. As the drive takes a little bit of contact, holds his own and puts it in. So Gontz and Glada both starting to feel it a little bit, you can tell, at the start of the second half.
Yeah, you could tell these two guys that would make the team go. They're trying to pick it up here in the second half.
If I'm not mistaken, they've both been on the floor the entire game, too. I don't recall seeing them subbed off.
No, not at all. I wouldn't put these guys down either.
Here's Gontz.
Look!
No look pass to Pedo, yeah. I was going to say no look pass to Pedo, but also no look from Pedo. And Hassan thinks about the shot, doesn't take it. Here's Gontz for Soderberg. Soderberg's closed down by Fitzpatrick.
You're going to get an outside shot.
Good quick pass
here
to Pedo. Didn't even turn around again.
Gons forcing the issue.
Yeah, he drives. He's going to get himself two shots. So make both of these. You could extend the lead to 6. And Gons from the line. Nice physical play from Gons, but again, you saw two or three times there. Pato gets the ball at the free throw line rather, and doesn't even have a glance at the hoop. So you wonder if next time out, coach is going to have something to say to him.
That would have been a halftime adjustment. He was doing that in the first half too. You get the ball there. You got plenty of space. You know, I'm not going to keep harping on it. You know, if he see it, hopefully he see it soon and force the issue there at the free throw line.
Of course, St. Charles West, coached by Pat Steinhoff, should mention Zumwalt North, coached by Charles Glada. And it's going to be a timeout taken by Zumwalt North. While we have a break, do you know a young man thinking about being a future cadet? If so, please encourage him to pay us a visit and experience CBC for himself. A shadow visit is the best way to learn more about the great things that are happening at CBC every day. And even now, you don't have to be in eighth grade anymore. Seventh grade shadowing is now available. Call Mrs. Melissa Ryan to schedule your shadow visit or a private family tour with the admissions director, Jim Brockman, a tour of CBC today. Call her at 314-985-6095. and make your plans to pay us a visit. That's 314-985-6095. I want to thank our friends in the admissions office, Jim and Mel Ryan. They certainly do a great job in the admissions, and they're very generous in their support also of the Cadet Student Network. So we certainly want to thank them. And in addition, we mentioned this in the first half, but a long, proud tradition of this tournament here. CBC would like to thank all the teams competing this week as we honor D.C. Wilcutt, a legendary coach, educator, and administrator who spent 35 years at CBC. During his career, Coach Wilcutt led the Cadets to 3 state championships, 14 district titles, and a total of 570 wins. He is a member of the Missouri State Coaches Hall of Fame. But most important, Coach was a mentor and friend to so many during his time at CBC, and we are so grateful for all he gave to our school. So, Coach, we hope you're watching and enjoying this always fun tournament. And certainly we hope you're going to be joining us for CBC Ladue in the championship game. Here's Pato.
Oh,
gets it to go.
He does have offense.
There we go.
I never knocked the kid, but I just think he's playing in the wrong position. I think someone else need to be at that elbow spot with his back towards the basket.
And Glad I can't get that to go.
He's just never been in that situation to have, you know, the responsibility to get the ball at the free throw line, back towards the basket, turn and face, and make decisions.
Boy, it's a small court, but it's amazing how much difference there is playing in different parts of it, isn't it?
Yeah. You got to know the spacing. Spacing of the zone, how to attack the zone. That is very important in the game of basketball.
And here is Glada. That one goes. So it's 30-27 now. St. Charles West with a 3-point lead. Again, they've led for the last maybe 2-3 minutes or so, and it was the first lead they have had since the opening seconds. Here is West. Pato turns, finds Hassan. A little more intent there. Here is Hassan. It's 1-on-1 with Glada. Moving his feet nice.
That was a quick 5 seconds.
All right, then. I think Hassan's a little bit confused. But it's going to be north ball.
It was 5 seconds closely guarded call. Good defense.
A lot of slips again. That one's off his leg. Pato fights for it, gains it. Still
soft
bouncing
flat
around. Off of Charles West, and it's going to be Zumwalt north ball.
Now they're going the other way with it.
Oh, well, we promise every once in a while the commentators and the officials see the same things. 2:21 to go, 30-27 still, in favor of St. Charles West. Shaping up to be a very exciting but we still got 2 minutes left in the third. Here's Gantz. Dumps in the corner for Hassan.
He eats from there.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yep.
That was absolutely, you could tell right out of his hand.
That's his spot. He hit. That's the second one he hit from the side corner there. Nice give and go there by the.
And I was going to say extended the lead to 6, but it's now cut down to 4.
Off the Glada.
Yep.
You can see Hassan. He's running to his corner. He wants it again.
Nice agile move there from Coach Steinhoff. See a ball coming right at him. See a little juke move to get out of the way. And there's Hassan on a drive.
Nice.
Yeah, he gets the basket, and they're going to give it to him.
That's a big difference now. You know, he hit a couple of them from outside. You run out of him, try to close out on defense, and he drive right by you, force you to foul.
Right, and that also opens up opportunities for the Gonses and Soderbergs of the world as well. Because all of a sudden, you know, the attention of Zumwalt North right now is squarely fixed, and rightfully so, on Hassan Dekarolis. So I think you have to, if you're Zumwalt North, have the mental discipline to say, yes, we need to be worried about this guy, but we can't just kind of shift all of our attention to him, because then you lose a lot of other people, and this game could get out of hand if you do that. So we have a timeout with 1:30 to go in the third quarter. While we have a second, we would like to thank our presenting sponsor, Tim Kylo, State Farm agent and CBC alum. He is a State Farm insurance agent, and so definitely if you need Insurance, you want to give him a call. He's not just the best insurance guy in town. He's also our presenting sponsor, as we said. And we're incredibly grateful for his support. Call Tim at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. So a minute and a half to go. 7-point game. You got a prediction in this one, Corey?
I would go with Zumwalt North. They're going to
really
come
think
back.
They're going to rally a little bit?
Yeah. Galata's going to turn it up here in a second.
Well, he's got the ball. We'll see if he can.
Try to split two defenders.
That didn't work out.
Oh,
ooh,
get it right
good
back.
Hustle there from Fitzpatrick. Can he take it? No, he can't. But he's going to pass
that's
it back
travel.
Out.
He got bailed out on the travel there.
Yeah, bodies are flying. That was definitely physical from Sam Bartlett. And Fitzpatrick's going to get to the inbound. Zumwalt North, they could use a few here. With a minute and 20 to go in the third quarter. Here's Fitzpatrick.
Man, that is a nice inbound play.
It is.
They can't finish.
Unfortunately, Bartlett just can't get it to go. And dumped in the corner for Hassan. Back in for Pato.
Pato score, young man.
Hassan with the three. That one looked good all the way, but just a little short.
He was going the other way on that one.
Here's Galata.
Forcing it.
Good defense from Pato, but not the best pass. Galata again.
Zach from deep.
Oh.
No good. Over the back. Out there by Hassan.
I think that was Coach Galata. They may know each other. And Coach is just kind of letting them know that might not be the most high percentage shot to take. And 45 seconds to go here. Here's Gantz to Soderberg. Soderberg bringing it up. Finds Gantz again. Gantz being marked by Fitzpatrick.
Well,
Orf.
I'm going to hold for the last shot.
Yeah, he's got to hold it for 23 more seconds.
Yep. And no rush whatsoever, up by 7.
And here's Gantz, good pick from Whitney. See, working it around the outside, and inside of 10 now. Now's about the time. Gantz pulls the trigger, can't get it to go. Soderberg can't get the rebound. That looks like it's off of Zumwalt North. It was off of the leg of Justin Fitzpatrick. So with 3 seconds to go, West is going to have an inbound, leading by 7. Gantz under the hoop.
That's his spot.
For Hassan, good drawn,
boom,
well drawn up play and a good good shot there. 10 points now is the lead. So an excellent shot from Hassan Dekarolis. We are going to go to a word from one of our sponsors. When we get back, we will have the fourth quarter here on the Cadet Student
Network.
You get
a 2-week free trial. So come get better, maximize your athletic potential.
World-class sports performance at the Lab Gym, St. Louis's premier training facility for elite and developmental athletes. Do you want to maximize your athletic potential? Do you want to get bigger, faster, stronger, more powerful, and actively prevent injuries? From high school and college to professional and Olympic athletes, world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym will get you ready to compete at the highest level. Call Director of Sports Performance, Matt Miller, 432 70 or visit their website labgym.com or just stop into the gym at 5035 Manchester Avenue to see for yourself.
Hey guys, this is Matt Miller with World Class Sports Performance at the Lab Gym. Make sure to check us out online, stop by, get a free tour. If you mention you're a friend of CBC, you get a 2-week free tour. So come get better, maximize your athletic potential.
And we welcome you back here. We're getting set for the inbound. Beginning of the fourth quarter here. 10-point game. Charles West must have heard your prediction, Corey. they're trying to take it to Zumwalt North. So now would be the time, if you're North, to start putting a few on the board. And that's the guy to do it. Glada takes a shot. Still can't get it to go. He hit two early on and hasn't hit another one since. I mean, he's sitting on 12 points, but based on the number of shots he's had, I think you would expect that to be a little higher. Here's Gantz. Leading scorer out there for, no, correction, was the leading scorer. Soderberg can't get it to go. But leading scorer is Hassan Dekarolis with 15. Gantz has 10. And good block from behind there. That was Pato. Been very good defensively tonight. Here's Soderberg.
Zumwalt North just don't have any other scorers.
No.
You know, in St. Charles West, you have Pons who can get inside, can shoot outside. Then you have Hassan hot in his corner. You got Soderberg can shoot from outside. And Timmy will make his close range layups every once in a while. So you have scorers. Zumwalt North, it's hard to figure out who's going to score the ball outside of Galata.
And even if he's going to score the basketball based
right.
on the...
And that's why they struggle. That's why they went 29 points here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, based on the amount of metal he's hit tonight.
This is a tall kid.
That he is.
His first minute of action.
So here's Soderberg. He's got a sign on the near corner. He's got Gantz over there on the far side, Whitney in the middle, Pato at the free throw line. And got to move it a little bit. There he is. And Soderberg being marked by Schwett, who's he's been out for a while, but really, again, I thought pretty good in the first half. I think maybe coach just gave him a rest and said, go out there, get me some rebounds. We need him.
He's playing a point of the – He's about 6'8 on the perimeter. I don't think he can keep up with the smaller guys of Lance, with Logan Ponce. Ponce has almost got a smirk on his face like, Coach,
really?
Are you, yeah. Yeah, this guy's going to guard me?
Is this a trick?
Yeah.
Yeah, and I guess, I mean, you've got a lot of strength inside right now. I mean, you have Wilson, you have Fitzpatrick, and you have Bartlett. So there's a lot of muscle in there. But, again...
The more athletic lateral movement guy on the ball, and I don't think, you know, Austin is that guy to do that.
5.5 to go.
St. Charles is very content with stalling. Has no problem with it. Here's Hassan again from deep.
Oh, man.
He is feeling it.
Yeah, he is. That's points number 16, 17, and 18 all being added at once. 42-29 now. Boy, your prediction's starting to look worse by the minute here, Corey.
Oh, I didn't say
it. Well, Glotta now. now he's coming good here. He puts one in. So 11 points, which is still certainly not insurmountable in 5 minutes of basketball. You still got about 5 minutes of basketball and 8 minutes of timeout still left in this game. So
I only said that to keep the viewers tuned in.
Of course, of course.
A lot of contact down low.
Every commentator's out.
If I would have said St. Charles West is going to run away with this, everybody would have turned
off. No commentator has ever tried to sway the viewers, your viewers' perspective of a game. Corey, what are you suggesting here? We'll move on from that one. 4:45 to go. Glotta hits the iron again.
Burns his own rebound down.
And is anybody else going to shoot in the rest of this game is the question. There's Wilson inside. Out to Schwett.
Oh, that's a shot or maybe
not.
There's
a lot of contact on Schwett. I think he ran into somebody's shoulder. Nothing given.
Well, was that a shot or was he tossing the alley hoop there?
We'll be charitable and say there was a miscommunication on the alley-oop. That's being very kind to
Schwett.
Austin Schwett. Looking for a first name there.
And he's playing the point.
And to his credit, his feet are very quick for as tall as he is.
No.
I mean, there you see him getting rounded a little bit.
no.
But...
I'm sorry.
All right, all right. I tried.
He is out of position.
He is out of position.
And then coach recognized it. Now you see he put his son, Zach, up there. and Fitzpatrick. Now this makes a lot more sense.
Dan. Now here's Soderberg. 4 minutes to go. 11-point lead for St. Guess which team is not in a hurry here. Here's Soderberg again. Hassan fakes it. Fitzpatrick steps. Ooh, glad I thought he had one there. Nice job by Soderberger recognizing, getting the
now
ball away
switch,
from
him. Now the switch, back
here's,
on.
Oh, they had Hassan with a shot there. Just couldn't quite find him.
He may not see another shot in this ball game.
No. No.
Unless it's a free throw.
3:18 now to go.
This is why I'm in favor of a shot clock. You know, everything is rushed in sports and life nowadays, you know, since the invention of microwave.
Of course. Single-handedly blaming the microwave for the shot clock, I see.
Anyway. Why not have a shot clock? Timmy.
And he puts that one in. So there's two more, so stretch the lead to 13.
Tommy, not Timmy. I'm
Tommy
sorry.
Whitney, of course, getting point number 5 there. So you think a shot clock in high school basketball?
Why not? It forced more strategy.
Now I guess this is kind of a moot point given the play clock, I guess, in football. But is part of the reasoning maybe not? I'm just trying to think from that perspective. Is part of the reasoning that a lot of gyms don't have the ability to have a shot clock above the hoop?
No. I mean, that's just another equipment tool, just the possession arrow. You know, it was one time where they didn't have possession arrows. It's something, if you have a shot clock, if you have a scoreboard, you should be able to have a shot clock.
Even if it's only on one side of the gym?
Yeah, I don't know how much one of those costs, but I've seen some of these schools, and... affording two shot clocks is not a big deal to some of these schools.
If there's anybody the higher ups of high school sport watching us, you can tweet Coach Bethany your thoughts at CBCCSN.
Hashtag shot clock.
Hashtag shot clock. You heard it here first. And Glada again rattles it out. How frustrated
man,
is he right now?
Man, really need that one to go in. Panthers.
And you see a little bit of show of frustration there. And you figure, you know, that shot really needs to go. If that shot goes,
it's an 8-point lead.
It's an 8-point lead. But right now, with a minute 20 seconds, and now there's another one for Charles West. So that is going to be 13 points. 10 to go in this one.
That's a nice move.
Yeah, it was a nice move there. It's the first action we've seen of Jared Jadwin. It was a nice move. Couldn't quite get it to go, but it's a good good turn. Here's Soderberg.
You got a foul here. Foul is a one-on-one situation.
I guess, is it a sign that he stepped out of bounds there? That's not what you want to do. Is it a sign they've given up that they're not fouling?
No, because that was good, hard defense, solid defense there. I mean, if they don't get any points on this time down, and probably
– oh!
That's the issue.
I think the issue is your prediction. So I think what you need to predict, Corey, what you need to predict is that Zumwalt North will not do anything in the next 40.8 seconds, and
I'm
then maybe we'll have something here.
10-point lead there. You see how deep he was on that?
You said it. I was thinking probably not going to see any more points here. Boy, that thing almost hit the rafters.
Yeah.
There's another hoop folded up into the ceiling, and he almost put it through that one. For a second, I thought he was aiming for the wrong one. But 40.8 seconds to go. While we do have a second, we want to thank all of our sponsors here on CSN. That includes the Lab Gym on Manchester Road, Millpaws Piping and Supply, Let's Party Now Catering, Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas. These loyal businesses make this broadcast possible, so be sure to support our sponsors. Also, the CBC Alumni Association, our admissions department, also sponsors CSN. Again, we said in the first half we couldn't do this without our students. We talk into the microphone. That is literally all we do. They do all the planning, all the budgeting, all the setup, everything. They're running this business. Max Adamski, Johnny Althoff, John McQuaid, Kyle Hunt, John Rolfe, Tony Gambino, all working on tonight's broadcast. Gentlemen, thank you for everything you've done to make CSN possible. And here's Charles West. They're looking to just hold on to it a little bit. And they're going to call a timeout. Yeah, it looked like Soderberg got the timeout call in. So 31.3 seconds. He was trapped in possession, just didn't want to give it up. So again, a 10-point game with 31 seconds to go. Well, if you're watching and you want to maximize your athletic potential, you should join World Class Sports Performance at the Lab Chester Road. Matt Miller and his team train high school, college, professional, even Olympic athletes. He gets you ready to compete at the highest level. Mention the Friends of CBC discount offer and you will receive a 2-week free trial of sports performance training. Call Matt at the Lab Gym, 314-932-7270, or visit their website at labgym.com/sports. And again, when you contact the Lab Gym, be sure to mention and request the Friends of CBC discount.
I have to get out there one day.
Well, I was going to say something, Corey, but... For the record, I'm just kidding, folks.
I guess someday soon, then.
It is the new year. It is the new year. So with 18 seconds, Charles West is going to toss this one around a little
play
bit.
Keep away.
Yep. Soderberg thinks about it, but doesn't think about it. And Glada gets his hands on it. Good heart from Glada, and that's a jump ball, but it's going to go to St. Charles West. And with 9.7 seconds to go, Charles West is going to have it under the hoop. I think we could probably maybe start this one as we see the last few seconds. Your thoughts overall on the performance from Charles West tonight?
They did what they had to do to get it done. Unfortunately for Zumwalt North, they just couldn't make the shots. They couldn't get the shots to fall down. Their main guy was off tonight, and you know that's what happens when you can't get anyone else to step up and score.
Well, and that's going to do it for the third place game. So congratulations to the Warriors from St. Charles West for wrapping up the third place here at the DC Wilcutt Tournament at CBC. Last thing we have to do, of course, on the broadcast is give the award to the game, and I think we have to give it to the one name we were hoping we wouldn't have to pronounce, but he proved us wrong. Hassan Decarolis DeCarolis. We got to make sure we get his name right because he is the MVP tonight. I think he has to be.
And they just announced it.
Yeah, the game MVP.
Big threes, big time threes down the stretch.
Especially
an and one.
The game was nearing on stalemate. You had two teams kind of canceling each other out. Not a lot of scoring going on. And then he just stepped up and started hitting three after three after three. He finishes with 18 points, and you got to give it to him. So that's going to do it for our broadcast of this game. We're going to take a little bit of a break. We'll come back shortly, just about 8 o'clock, and we will bring you versus Ladue in the championship game of the DC Wilcutt Tournament. So that's going to do it for now. For Corey Bethany and all of us here at CSN, I'm Tom Eichwell. We want to thank you, and we will see you in just a few minutes for CBC Ladue.